Welcome to the fourth video lecture on basic electrical module 3. So in this we will be seeing the current as well as the power in a series RL circuit fed from an AC supply. So consider the RL circuit given in the figure. In this, a resistance of value R and an inductor of value L is connected in series across a supply voltage of Vm sin omega t. So if the inductance value is L, then the inductive reactance XL is obtained as omega L or 2 pi FL. So let V be the RMS value of your applied voltage. That is, V is actually Vm by root 2. And I be the RMS value of applied current. Then, the voltage drop across the inductor, VL is equal to I into XL. And the voltage drop across the capacitor, VR, that is equal to I into R. So our aim is to find the current through the circuit as well as the power dissipated in this circuit. So in order to find the current through the circuit, first we need to draw your phasor diagram. So for drawing a phasor diagram, we always want a reference phasor. Usually the parameter which is common to all the elements is taken as the reference phasor. Here it is a series circuit. So we know that the current in a series circuit is the same. So current through R is same as the current through L, which is equal to I. So the current is taken as the reference phasor. The reference phasor is always drawn horizontal. So first of all, we can draw the current phasor just like this. So this is your current phasor. Next, we need to draw the voltage phasor. First of all, the voltage across resistance VR. We know that for a purely resistive circuit, the current is in phase with the voltage. This relation we have already derived. So we know that VR is in phase with your current. So VR phasor can be drawn like this, in phase with the current. So in the straight line as that of your current. So that is the VR phasor. Next is the voltage across the inductor. So we have already derived that for a purely inductive circuit, the voltage leads the current by 90 degree. So what will happen? The voltage lead the current. VL will lead the current by 90 degree. So leading parameter should be always drawn upwards. By how many degrees? 90 degrees. So this is your VL. So we have drawn the current phasor, VR phasor and VL phasor. Then the total supply voltage, that is V, is the vector sum of VR and VL. So VL, V phasor will be the vector sum of VR and VL. So like this. So here we can see that the resultant current makes an angle with the resultant voltage, and this angle is known as the phase angle phi or the power factor angle. Next, we need to derive the relationship between all these parameters. So this is a phasor diagram. From the phasor diagram, we can see that the power factor angle phi, that is tan phi, is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, right? So tan phi is equal to VL by VR, or phi can be written as tan inverse VL by VR. Then power factor, that is power factor is cosine of angle between the voltage and current, or it is cos phi. So cos phi is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, so VR by V. So this is a relationship between the power factor and power factor angles. Next, we need to find out the resultant voltage. So resultant voltage V, that is the vector sum of VL and VR. So from the phasor diagram, we will be getting V is root of VR square plus VL square. So substituting for VR, we know that VR is equal to I into R and VL is equal to I into XL. We will be getting it as equal to root of IR square plus IXL the square. That is equal to, taking I common outside, V is equal to I into root of R square by XL square. V by I, that is your impedance value. That is the total opposition offered by the circuit to the current. That is known as the impedance. So impedance Z is equal to root of R square plus XL square. So based upon this relationship, we can draw a triangle, right? This is in the form hypotenuse is equal to root of base square plus altitude square. So it's actually a right triangle in this form. Here we are having the resistance, here having the inductance in the place of VR and VL, and this is your resultant impedance. The angle between your resistance and impedance, it is phi. From this voltage triangle, similar to this voltage triangle, we have drawn an impedance triangle based upon the relation Z is equal to root of R square plus XL square. So from this triangle also, we can find the relation equations for phi and cos phi. So from this we can see that phi is equal to tan inverse or XL by R, opposite side by adjacent side. Also power factor, that is cos phi, is equal to R by Z. So these equations that will come handy while doing the numericals. Next, we can find the power consumed in a series RL circuit. We had already determined that out of the three circuit elements, that is the resistor, inductor and capacitor, the only power consuming element is the resistor. In the case of an inductor and a capacitor, the average power consumed in an entire cycle is zero. This result we have already derived in the previous classes. So the power consumed in a series RL circuit will be equal to the power consumed by your resistance. So average power consumed, that is P, or the average power consumed, that is same as your active power, or power that is available for the useful work. So P is equal to power consumed in the resistance, that is voltage across resistance into current. Whatever be the circuit, power will always be voltage into current. So voltage across your resistance into current. From the phasor diagram, we can see that the voltage across the resistance, it is VR, that will be equal to V cos phi, because cos phi is VR by V. So VR is equal to V cos phi, because when a circuit is given, we will be only know the total supply voltage. Okay. So we can write VR is equal to V cos phi. Substituting for VR in the above equation, we will be getting power as VI cos phi, where V and I are the RMS value of the supply voltage and current. and cos phi is the power factor of the circuit. So this is regarding the active power. Then second component of the power in the case of an AC network is your reactive power. This reactive power is the power that is circulating in inductor as well as the capacitor. And this reactive power will not be available for useful work because this power will be circulating in your circuit elements such as inductor and capacitor. So here we are having an inductor. So the power circulating in the inductor, that is your reactive power, or it is denoted by the letter Q. So reactive power Q is equal to VL into I, that is the volt power consumed by power in your inductor or power circulating in the inductor. So that is VL into I. Then from the phasor diagram we can see that VL means that is V sin phi, because sin phi is VL by V. So VL will be V sin phi. Substituting for that, we'll be getting reactive power Q is equal to VI sin phi. Next, we can see some of the problems in RL circuit. Please go through this question. A 10 ohm resistor and a 300 millihenry inductor are connected in series to a 230 volt sinusoidal supply. The circuit current is 4 ampere. Calculate the supply frequency and phase angle between voltage and current. So whenever we get a question, first of all check the nature of the circuit. So here we can see that a 10 ohm resistor and a 300 millihenry inductor are connected in series. So this is a series RL circuit. Next, we can write the given parameters using their standard notation. So here given R is equal to 10 ohm. Then inductor value. Inductor means that is your L. L is equal to 300 millihenry or 300 into 10 raised to minus 3 henries. Then voltage. Supply voltage, that is V equal to 230 volt. Then supply current I equal to 4 ampere. So here we will have a doubt whether the given voltage or given current are the RMS value or whether it's an average value or whether it's a peak value. We can see that in the question it is nothing mentioned regarding the nature of this voltage. So if nothing is mentioned, then the given voltage will be your RMS value of the voltage. Otherwise it will be specified. For instance, the peak supply voltage is 250 volt or the average value of voltage is 200 volt or something like that, it will be specified. If nothing is specified about the nature of the voltage, then it is an RMS value. So here we can say that VRMS is 230 volt and IRMS is 4 ampere. And in the question, we need to calculate the supply frequency F and also phase angle phi. Then since voltage and current is given, we can find the impedance of the circuit. Impedance is actually the opposition offered by the circuit to the flow of current. So impedance Z is equal to V by I, that is 230 by 4, which is equal to 57.5 ohm. We know that for an RL circuit, impedance Z is also equal to root of R square plus XL square. So from that, we can find the inductive reactance XL is equal to root of Z square minus R square. Okay, so substituting, we will be getting the value for XL. Now, the XL is omega into L, where omega is 2 pi FL. So, if we are able to find the inductive reactance value, we can find the supply frequency F of the circuit. So, from the above equation, we will be getting F as XL by 2 pi L. Substituting, we will be getting the frequency as 30 hertz. All the values are given in the question. So we got the supply frequency. Next, we need to find the phase angle phi between voltage and current. So already we have derived that the phase angle phi, that is equal to tan inverse XL by R. XL we know, R also we know. Substituting, we will be getting it as tan inverse 56.62 divided by 10, or phi is equal to 80 degrees. Okay. Please go through the second question. So in this question, the instantaneous value of voltage and current is given as V of t is equal to 160 sine omega t plus 10 degree, and I of t is equal to 5 sine omega t minus 20 degree. We need to calculate power factor, power absorbed, as well as we have to draw the phasor diagram. So what about the nature of the circuit? Here we can see that the voltage is V 160 sine omega t plus 10 degree. That is, it is 10 degree ahead. And the current is 5 sine omega t minus 20 degree. So from the equation itself, it is clear that the current is lagging your voltage. So current lags the voltage in a RL circuit. So this is an RL circuit. Now we can write the given parameters. That is, V of t is 160 sine omega t plus 10, and I of t is 5 sine omega t minus 20 degree. First parameter we have to calculate is the power factor. Power factor is cos phi, where phi is the angle between the voltage and current. So from this equation, first we can find the angle between voltage and current. Okay, so phase angle phi is equal to angle of voltage, that is omega t plus 10 degree, minus that of current, minus omega t minus 20 degree. Subtracting, we will be getting it as 30 degree. So phase angle phi is equal to 30 degree. So the power factor cos phi, that is equal to cos 30, which is equal to 0.866. Next parameter we need to find is your active power, or the power absorbed. So we know that active power of any circuit, of any AC single phase AC circuit, is P equal to VI cos phi. That's equation for active power for a single phase AC circuit. Cos phi we already found out. Then what about V and I? Here the V and I, they are the RMS value of voltage and current. But in the question, the RMS value is not given. Instead of that, instantaneous value is given. Okay. So for instantaneous value of an AC voltage, that is generally of the format Vm sin omega t plus or minus phi. So from this equation, we can find the value for Vm, or the maximum value. That is, Vm will be equal to 160 volt. So we know that for a sine wave, the RMS value, V RMS, will be Vm by root 2. So that is equal to 160 by root 2. Then similarly, from the instantaneous value of current, we can get Im as 5 amperes. So IRMS will be Im by root 2, that is 5 by root 2. So substituting these two parameters in the equation for active power, we will be getting active power as P equal to 160 by root 2 into 5 by root 2 into 0.866. That is equal to 346.41 watts. Okay. Next, we have to draw the phasor diagram. So before drawing the phasor diagram, first we can draw the axis. Okay. So this is our axis. Then, if the voltage equation was 160 sin omega t plus 10 degree, it's a given voltage equation. Okay. So, if it was 160 sin omega t, then your phasor will be along this axis. But it is 160 sin omega t plus 10 degree. That is, it will be rotating as 10 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. And now the phasor will be like this. Where the angle, this angle, that is 10. Okay. Similarly, if you are looking the current value, current is 5 sin omega t minus 20 degree. So minus means lagging, that means it should draw downwards. So this will be your current phasor. And this angle that will be your 20 degrees. Okay. So this will be the phasor diagram of the given circuit. Here we can see that current lags your voltage by a total angle of 30 degree. And the length of the phasor V that will be equal to your peak value 160 degree, and here it will be 5 amperes. Okay. So hope everyone is clear with the problems on RL circuit. So that it will be the end of this video lecture. Thank you.